हेलो स्टूडेंट, सो लेट सी द यूट्रस। इन आयुर्वेदा इट इज़ कॉल्ड द गर्भाशय। सो द यूट्रस इट इज़ आल्सो कॉल्ड द हिस्टेरा, हिस्टेरा दैट इज रिलेटेड विद द हिस्टेरेक्टॉमी। सो यूट्रस इट इज़ द चाइल्ड बियरिंग ऑर्गन प्रेजेंट इन द फीमेल एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स द सुटेबल साइट एंड द एनवायरमेंट फॉर द इम्प्लांटेशन ऑफ द फर्टिलाइज ओहम एंड द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द एम्ब्रियो। सो the uterus it is the hollow thick walled muscular organ with narrow lumen and it is situated obliquely into that the lesser pelvis in between that the urinary bladder and the rectum. Superiorly each side the uterus it is communicates with the uterine tube and inferiorly it is communicate with the vagina. So let's see that is the details of the uterus. So this is the uterus and it is piriform in shape. The measurement of the uterus that is the 3 inch, 2 inch and the 1 inch means that is the 3 inch in length, the 2 inch in the breadth and 1 inch in the thickness. The weight of the uterus that is near about 30 to 40 grams and it is divisible into the upper expanded part, it is called the body that is upper 2/3 part and the lower cylindrical part that is called the cervix that is the forming near about lower 1/3 part of the uterus. Then normally that is the long axis of the uterus forms the angle of about 90 degree long axis of the vagina that is the normal position of that uterus that is the anteroverted position. So here in this diagram you can see that is it should be forming near about the 90 degree angle with that the vagina and the anteroverted position it is the normal position. So here in the another diagram you can see that is this one that is the urinary bladder and into that the urinary bladder the uterus it should be convoluted. So that is called the anteroverted position of the uterus. So the parts of the uterus. So as you know that is the uterus it should be divided upper 2/3 part it is called the body and the lower 1/3 part it is called the cervix and the two parts that is the body and the cervix where it should be joined with each other. So this part it is called the isthmus, this one. So let's see first that is the body. So the body it is the upper expanded dome like end of the body it is called the fundus. So this one and it is passing through the opening of the uterine tube or the fallopian tubes on the both lateral sides. So here you can see that is the uterine tube. Then the body extends from the fundus to that the isthmus it contain the uterine cavity and it is flattened antero posteriorly and this body have the two surfaces and the two borders that is the anterior surface and the posterior surface and these are the two lateral borders. So let's see the anterior surface. So the anterior surface it is flat and directed downwards and the forwards and it is converted by or it is covered by the peritoneum up to that the isthmus where it is reflected to upper surface of the urinary bladder and forming the uterovesical pouch. So in the another diagram we can see here that is this is the uterus and this is the urinary bladder. So between this that is the fold of the peritoneum it should be present. So it is called the uterovesical pouch. Then the posterior surface, then the posterior surface it is the convex and it is directed upwards and the backwards and it is covered by peritoneum which extend downward up to the posterior fornix of the vagina and where it is reflected on the anterior aspect of the rectum to form the rectouterine pouch or that is called the pouch of Douglas. So here in this diagram you can see this is the rectum, this is the uterus and between them that is the fold of the peritoneum is present. So that is called the rectouterine pouch or the pouch of Douglas. Then the right and left lateral borders. So this is the right border, this is the left border. So both border is rounded and related to that the uterine artery. So here in the another diagram you can see there it is related with that the uterine artery, both lateral side. Then it is non-peritoneal for provide the attachment of the broad ligament of the uterus, and the uterine tube enters into the uterus at the upper end of this border. So here you can see that is this blue color, this is the broad ligament is present. So here you can see that is the broad ligament and this border are related with that the uterine artery. And on the upper side here, the upper border of the broad ligament here, that is the uterine tube, that should be enters on both side into that the uterus. Then the round ligament of the uterus. So here you can see that is the round ligament of the uterus. It is attached to that the anteroinferior to the uterine tube. So here, and its ligament of the ovary. So here you can see that is the ligament of ovary. It is attached to the posterior inferior to that the tube. So here from that is the both lateral side, that is these two ligaments it should be attached, that is the round ligament of the uterus and the ligament of the ovary. So this one. After then, that is the cervix, means this lower part. So it is the lower cylindrical part and its lower part project into the upper part of the vagina. So this one, through that the anterior wall. So that is the cervix, it should be divided into that the two parts, that is the supravaginal part and the lower vaginal part. So here in this diagram you can see that is this is the vagina and this is the cervix of the uterus. So part of the uterus which is present into that the vagina, so that is called the vaginal part, and the upper part which is not present into that the vagina, so that is called the supravaginal part. And clinically the isthmus, it is formed by the upper one third of the supravaginal cervix. So here that is the as the isthmus is present. Then the relations of the uterus. The relations of the uterus. So here you can see that is the uterus and this is the vagina. So anterior relation firstly. So anteriorly it is related with the double fold of the peritoneum, that is called the uterovesical pouch. So here, and the urinary bladder. So that is the anterior relation. Then the posterior relation of the uterus. So posteriorly it is related with the rectouterine pouch. So here you can see, or that is called the pouch of Douglas, which is the double fold of the peritoneum. Then on the lateral side, both here in this diagram you can see that is the broad ligament of uterus and that is the uterine artery. So this one. Then the supravaginal part of the uterus, means that is the upper part of the cervix. So it is related with the ureter and the uterine artery. So here ureter and this is the uterine artery. And the vaginal part, it is related with that is the lateral fornix of the vagina. So this one, both side, lateral fornix of the vagina. Then let's see that is the cavity of the uterus. So that is the cavity of the uterus. So the cavity of the uterus, it is small in comparison to its size, that is due to its thick muscular wall, and it is divided into two parts by the cavity of the body, means this part, and the cavity of the cervix. Then let's see first the cavity of the body, or that is called the uterine cavity proper. So this one. So it is a triangular in coronal section, and the apex of the cavity, it should be continuous below with the cervical canal through that is the internal os. So this one here, that is called the internal os. The implantation of the developing embryo that should be occurs commonly in the upper part of the posterior wall of the cavity of the uterus. Then the cavity of the cervix. So this one. So it is the small spindle shaped canal being a broader in the middle and narrow at both ends. It communicates antero superiorly with the cavity of the body through the internal os. So this one. And inferiorly with the cavity of vagina through, that is the external os. This one. Then in the nulliparous women, that is the external os, it is small and circular. So here you can see the another diagram here in the nulliparous female. It is small and the circular. And in the multiparous women, it is a external os, it is large and it is shows a transverse slit having both anterior and the posterior lip. So this one. After then, let's see that is the ligaments related with that the uterus. Then the arterial supply of the uterus. So uterus, it is supplied by mainly the two uterine arteries and partly the two ovarian arteries. So here you can see that is the uterine artery, this one, which is the branch of internal iliac artery. And this is the ovarian artery, so which is the direct branch from the abdominal aorta. So these artery both anastomoses to give the blood supply to that the uterus. Then the venous drainage, that is the veins of the uterus correspond to the arteries and they form the venous plexus along the lateral border of the uterus which drain into internal iliac veins through the uterine and the vaginal veins. After then, that is the lymphatic drainage. This is the lymphatic drainage, and the lymphatic drainage of the uterus, it is clinically very much important because the uterine cancer that should be spread through that the lymphatics. So first, that is from the fundus and the upper part of the body. So this is the fundus and this is the upper part of the body. So it should be drained into the pre and para aortic lymph nodes. Then from the lower part of the body, so this one, from this region, so it should be drained into the external iliac lymph nodes. So here, external iliac lymph nodes. Then from the cervix, so this one, so it should be drained in the three directions, that is laterally the lymph vessels drain into the external iliac lymph nodes, then posterolaterally the lymph vessel drain into the internal iliac lymph nodes, and posteriorly the lymph vessels drain into the sacral lymph nodes. So in this way, that is the lymphatic drainage that should be occurs. Then the nerve supply. So the uterus, it is richly innervated by both sympathetic and the parasympathetic nerve fibers. So the sympathetic fiber, they are derived from the T12 to L2 spinal segment, and it causes the contraction and the vasoconstriction of the uterus. Then the parasympathetic fibers derived from S2, S3 and S4 spinal segment, and it inhibit the uterine muscle and causes the vasodilatation. So these are the nerve supply. Then let's see that is the structure of the uterus. So the structure of the uterus. The wall of the uterus are composed of the three layers of the tissue, that is the perimetrium, myometrium and the endometrium from outer to inner side. Then first perimetrium. So this is the fold of the peritoneum which is distributed differently on the various surfaces of the uterus. So let's see first anteriorly. So anteriorly it lies over the fundus and the body, where it should be folded on the upper surface of the urinary bladder, and this fold of the peritoneum forms the vesico-uterine pouch. Then posteriorly, the peritoneum covers the fundus, body and the cervix. And then they fold back on the rectum to form the rectouterine pouch, or that is called the pouch of Douglas. And laterally, only the fundus is covered because the peritoneum forms a double fold with the uterine tube in the upper free border. Then the double fold of the broad ligament present or attached to the lateral side or the lateral border of the uterus. So that is called the broad ligament. So in the another diagram you can see here, that is, this is the double fold of the rectouterine pouch, and anteriorly same, that is the vesicouterine pouch is present, that is the double fold. So anteriorly, that is only covered the fundus and body, and rectovesical pouch that should be covered the fundus, body, and also that is the cervix, this one. And this is the broad ligament which is present to that the lateral border of the uterus, this one. Then let's see, that is the myometrium. Then the myometrium, it is the thickest layer of the tissue in the uterine wall, and the mass of the smooth muscle fiber interlaced with the areolar tissue, the blood vessels and the nerves. So that should be present into that the myometrium. Then the endometrium, or the inner layer, innermost layer. So it consists of the columnar epithelial cells containing a large number of the mucus secreting tubular gland, and it is divided functionally into that the two layers. That is, first is the functional layer, it is the upper layer and become rich with the blood vessels in the first half of the menstrual cycle, and this layer it is shed during the menstruation. Then the basal layer, it lies next to the myometrium and it is not lost during the menstruation, and it is the layer from which the fresh functional layer regenerated during each cycle. Then the upper 2/3 of the cervical region, it is lined with the mucous membrane, and the lower 1/3 of the mucosa, it should be changes to forming the squamous epithelium, which is continuous with the lining of the vagina. After then, that is, the structure of the cervix, it is different from the body, for it is not lined by the endometrium and it does not show the cyclic changes which is occurs into that the endometrium of the uterus. So this is the structure.